Rasta we'll select the expression below that is equivalent to the following. Add 8 and 8, then multiply by 8, then divide by 8. This problem involves the order of operations, which are outlined here below for review. The first step in the order of operations is to simplify within the innermost parentheses or grouping symbols. Step 2, simplify all expressions with exponents. Step 3, multiply and divide from left to right. And step 4, add and subtract from left to right. So there are a couple of approaches to this problem. For our first approach, we know the first step here is to add 8 and 8. Let's see if we can select the expressions where adding 8 and 8 would be the first step in simplifying. Looking at this first expression, notice how we have multiplication, addition, and division. And looking at step 3, notice how we multiply and divide from left to right before we add or subtract. And therefore, the first step here is not to add 8 and 8, it would be to multiply 8 and 8, which means this first expression would not be equivalent. Looking at the second expression, again, we have addition, multiplication, and division. And we know we multiply and divide before we add or subtract. So the first step in this expression is also to multiply 8 and 8, not add 8 and 8. So this expression will also not be equivalent. Looking at our next expression, the first step would be to simplify inside the parentheses. Notice inside the parentheses, we do have 8 plus 8. So this would be the first step, which means this expression may be equivalent to the expression stated here, even though we're just looking at the first step so far. Looking at the fourth expression, we simplify inside the parentheses first, but because we multiply and divide before we add and subtract, the first step here inside the parentheses, again, is to find the product of 8 and 8. So even after this first step, the only possible equivalent expression would be this third expression. But now let's also take a look at this another way. Let's write out the expression as it stated and see if we can make our expression match this third expression. So if our first step is to add 8 and 8, to make sure we do this first, let's put the quantity 8 plus 8 in parentheses, and then we're supposed to multiply by 8, that's right, times 8. And then the fourth step is to divide by 8, so to make sure we do this last, let's go ahead and put this in parentheses, and then divide by 8. Notice in this form, these expressions do not look the same, so let's see if they are equivalent. Looking inside the innermost parentheses, notice how we have 8 plus 8 in parentheses times 8, but because multiplication is commutative, meaning we can change ordered multiplication and it doesn't change the product, we can go ahead and write this as, in parentheses, 8 times the quantity 8 plus 8, and then divided by 8. Again, we can do this because multiplication is commutative. As an example, we know that 2 times 3 is equal to 3 times 2. Notice now the expressions look almost the same, except this expression here has an extra set of parentheses, which really aren't needed because notice how multiplication and division have the same priority. We multiply and divide as it occurs from left to right. So with or without these outer parentheses, we would multiply before we would divide. So we can write this as just 8 times the quantity 8 plus 8 divided by 8, which is the same as expression 3. Verifying our answer is correct. Now it doesn't ask, but let's also go ahead and simplify this. The first step would be to simplify inside the parentheses. Notice how we have 8 plus 8 in parentheses, which is 16. This would simplify to 8 times 8 divided by 8. Now we multiply and divide from left to right. 8 times 8 is 64, so we have 64 divided by 8, which equals 8. I hope you found this helpful.